1 second. He told me to start it. No problem, Susie. I usually stay up till 2 a.m. anyway, and it's 11:28 for me. So I got 2.5 hours. Do you guys want to do a Q&A until they get on here? I don't know if you guys know my backstory. I've shared it within the group. I like to usually play League of Legends. I just got my PS4 fix. I play sports games on PlayStation. I played a lot of MMORPG games. But unfortunately, that genre is kind of dead right now. That's about it. And also, what I was gonna continue on was some of you may already know this, but I used to be an actor back in 2011 for Russ when it was considered a boo haunt. But it was more in between a boo haunt and an extreme haunt. I mean, Russ would give the orders, Lindsay, and people would just, like, do what Russ said because it's like Russ's haunt, you know? Otherwise you get fired, basically. It's basically your boss. So, and then, yeah, I answered that. Well, I mean, so Russ turned it into a kidnapping simulation, like, after 2014, and I acted back in 2011 when they consider it a boo haunt, even though it was more of, like, in between a boo haunt and the kidnapping extreme simulation thing. No, the actors were more, like, we would hug, like, we would bear hug people going through the haunt and wrestle with them, get in their faces, like, nothing serious at the time. So basically, Lindsay asked how or why did you leave the haunt. My So it's a long story, but my friend basically, okay, so Russ owns like this big red van, right? And as a kid, my friend was 12 years old at the time, I was 11, and he would like reward the kid actors with like candy and stuff, and he had like and like pizza and other goodies, and he also owned a big red van, so you would automatically think that's your stereotypical like movie type like predator, you know? And especially as a kid, like we would make jokes about stereotypes. So my friend mentioned that they were basically, like he said, they act like pedos or whatever, and obviously it was like a joke at the time through kids. And they basically gave me an ultimatum that I could either continue working at the haunt or wait 1 second. Either I could continue working at the haunt or I could continue being friends, like with my good friend that I've known since kindergarten. So I chose the latter, and it's funny because before I even made the choice, Russ actually stalked my friend to see if we were hanging out in public. Like my friend went to the movie theaters in the neighborhood. And Russ like swung by there, and I think he started yelling at my friend about the whole situation, and he also made my friend cry over the phone about it. And again, he was 12 years old at the time, so he's doing this to a kid. And then also, what am I forgetting? They just got like, they didn't want me like acting if I was still friends with them because of what was like said as a joke. And the worst thing I personally witnessed was just like mind games from Russ. There wasn't really anything that was like super physical at the time because he obviously employed kid actors, so he couldn't really make it insane until he hired all the adult actors. And the thing about none of that sounds like a pedo, but and yeah, I know none of it sounds like a pedo, but like, you know those like Stranger Danger type videos, like where they say, "Oh, if there's a person in a white van that is like trying to get you to come to their car with candy or something, like it's a predator trying to bait you in." Like it was just a stereotype thing that we were just joking about, and it got blown out of proportion by Russ, and then and then I was basically forced to make that decision. Okay, well, I mean, it's the internet, so I can't really tell what you're if you're using sarcasm or not. Yeah, I agree, Susie. I'm pretty sure he had his own trauma going on as a child, which he developed some bad traits due to whatever he experienced. No, he actually has a good side to him. The worst he did around the kid actors was yell at us if we screwed up one of our parts in one of the group tours that like we held every Friday and Saturday night in September and October. but he never was really like threatening in a physical way, at least to the kid actors. I mean, he did some pretty creepy ass shit, obviously, from what I've mentioned, but that's about it. All right, 1 second. Sorry, I didn't. Josh,
you finally
are you there?
Seen us.
Sorry.
Yeah,
dude. Sorry about that. Yeah, I was just answering Q&A while I was waiting for you guys.
Shit, can you still hear me?
Yeah, I can see you.
Shit, and I've just cut my whole fucking phone off somehow. I'm trying to get it on this stupid stand. Hold on. Before I start this, let me make sure we got Laura in here. Or Lori.
Okay.
Let's not call her Laura. Name is Lori. She likes Lori, not Laura. Everybody remember that. Blah, 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 blah.
Yeah, Susie, he took the haunt very seriously. I think it's just he tunnel visions too hard on it, and he doesn't realize he's hurting other people in the process.
And Brendan, I just need to ask you something real quick up front. This is probably going to be recorded, and I hope you're ready to get sad as fuck, because I look like shit right now because Lori just made me cry for the past 25 minutes, and that's what took me so long to get here. This shit's about to be really fucking sad, and I don't know how many people you have watching right now, or
13.
How many ever many. Well,
there's 13.
If those 13 people can share this with 13 other people, this shit's really getting ready to go down in full, and it's gonna go down again on Ron's podcast as well. But Lori, trust me enough to do this, so. This is about to be really intensely fucking sad, and it's probably gonna. It's.
I'm gonna add her in right now.
Okay.
All right.
Oh, so she joined.
Yeah. There she is.
Ah, there she is. The myth, the legend.
Hey, how's it going?
Hey, sorry. Give me a second. I'm putting my Bluetooth in.
Okay, no problem. Take your time. Yeah.
Oh no. I'm trying to. Put my phone on the
Hold on one thing. Second.
Okay. Are we good?
Okay, for some reason I can't get my headset connected, so.
Of course. Something has to go wrong every single time something has to go wrong.
Yeah.
Look at that smile, though. That is so opposite of what I was just listening to. I'm so happy you are smiling right now. So happy. So, Brendan, I don't know how you feel about me, like, asking her questions on your page and shit, since I don't know how to use this bullshit.
no, you can rattle off. I'm gonna let you guys talk.
I'm gonna
be quiet.
So, Lori, not Laura, Lori, for the masses, don't call her Laura. She will cuss you out. That is a very special phrase for only family members. So, why don't you just tell people who you are? Introduce yourself.
I don't know why I can't hear you through my Bluetooth.
Can't hear me at all through your Bluetooth?
I'm trying it again.
We've had tech issues all day. Facebook sucks ass, so we came
weird.
Up with this random red website.
But, all right, whatever.
Oh, gosh. I mean,
let's do this.
Okay, you sure? 100%.
100%.
Because you know, like I told you, we don't have to do this. Ah, but now I can't hear you because your Bluetooth.
Oh, you can't hear me because of my Bluetooth?
Oh, I can hear you now. Okay, so Okay, now you say something so we make sure the audio is good.
Hi, everyone.
So you can hear me good.
I can hear you. I just have to like keep my phone closer to me because the audio is not going through my Bluetooth.
Well, that's good because then we all get such a much better look at your face. So for now, until people start crying, it's awesome. So, so for the people who don't know who you are, the completely bread dead or brain dead, dumb, dumb doo doo heads that don't know who you are, let's just pretend that everyone is a potato. Just introduce yourself and how you came across this shit show.
I'd love to. Hey everyone, my name is Laura Hertz Brotherton, but I go by Lori. I was introduced to McCamey Manor in 2015. I love haunted houses. I love Halloween, and there was just something that like I just needed more. Like you go through haunted houses, and they're just like boo boo boo. You know, I wanted something a little more spicy. So it just happened that I was healing from a surgery. I was healing from a gallbladder surgery. And as I was healing, I started Googling scariest haunted houses in Colorado. And it just so happened that when I was Googling it, McCamey Manor was the first site that came up on Google for an interactive haunt in San Diego, California. So I was kind of intrigued in it. I was interested. And so I went on the website. I got in contact with Russ McCamey. And it just turned into a little shit show from like the day I contacted this man until right now as you're looking at me. I've never in a million years thought that what happened to me really happened. It was bad. What I thought, what I was getting into was not what happened to me. I did my research. I looked at every single solitary movie that Russ had ever made in all the years through McCamey Manor. And I looked at what the people went through, and what they went through did not, what was not I went through. What I went through was personal. Ross had a personal vendetta against me for just the most ridiculous reasons, but even still, like, I still to this day don't know, and I don't think I ever know why he had done to me what was done to me. But here I am now, alive, happy as ever, meeting some of the some great people like Josh. Hi, Josh.
It's so crazy because we're literally like, people don't even know this is the first time we have ever seen each other like on a camera. So like,
yeah,
some of this stuff like I've already cried about, and you're gonna make me cry about it again. So like, I'm literally just trying to like brace myself. And
because, oh well, then let like, me join you, my friend, here.
Yes. Cheers. The cheers. Official cheers to this. Holy shit.
Yeah.
So
what do you got for me? I'm willing. I'm ready. I everything that happened to me, I want it known. I want every single solitary person that has anything to do with Russ McCamey and his McCamey Manor bullshit lying tours. I want them to know the truth. I want them to know what really happened to me. I want to finally speak out and be a voice to others that want to go through his haunt. And I want to be the person to warn them of what could honestly happen. What I went through was It was undescribable. I mean, it is describable, but I don't think many other people would have been able to go through the future part of their life the way I did.
I personally can say I'm very amazed and proud of the woman that you became from the last time I heard about you, or, you know, seeing whatever posts or whatever. You're a very strong and very beautiful woman, and you have came way farther than anybody would have ever expected. So, round of applause for Lori. So, let's I guess the only really way is to start would be to start at the beginning. The beginning, when you first arrived, when you first, I guess, whatever you want to go from. You've already told me so much. I don't even really know what to describe this shit in a word. It's just please take this from me right now.
It was a lot. Yeah, Josh, it was a lot. From even like before I went to San Diego, it was a lot. They, like once Russ put my name out there and that I proved to him that I'm legit, about my plane ticket, everything, is when things just got crazy. From the beginning. Before I did my tour, Russ made it that during the month of October with me and my other contestants that we had to do these challenges, you know, like live challenges. I did so many challenges. I mean, I can't even count them all, but I do have a video of every single solitary thing that I did. I saved it. Yeah.
Smart girl.
Smart. it was just nuts. I was getting like private messages through Facebook from the actors maybe 3-4 times a day wanting me to do challenges. I did my challenges really good. I am not an introvert, as you can tell. I'm an extrovert. So when it was time for me to do my challenges, I went way above and beyond. I mean, they were amazing. Like one of them, I had to go into a Spirit Halloween store with my onesie on, and I had to sing "I Will Do Anything for Love, But I Won't Do That" by Meatloaf, dancing around romantically with the skeleton.
And you crushed it. And like, I know a lot of people haven't seen this, but you destroyed that shit. You did.
It was so funny. But I did it. I had to sing not one, but two of Mike Meekum's songs from the band of Litmus Green. He's like super, super like old school punk. And they never made it big. But, you know, I do have a guy at my work that has actually heard of them.
Do they bang on pots and pans too?
No, I didn't bang on any pots and pans. But, you know, every challenge that was presented to me was pure. That was me. I loved a lot of my challenges. And I excelled at them all. Like there was even a point where like, okay, you have to tell a really scary story. And I even still have my stories all written down, everything. I have so much stuff that I don't even know what to do with it except for put it out there and let people know that what I went through was not right. What I went through was personal. It was absolutely personal. It wasn't a tour. If anyone looked back on any McKamey Manor video or movie in the history of, 20 years that he's been doing this, not one single solitary person went through what I went through.
That's why it's, what is it? Hashtag Lori the Beast, right? So you got your stuff scheduled. You did your prelim silliness, which is apparently this weirdo's fucking thing. He likes to make people do silly shit on the internet. So let's move on to your point of contact. Like, when you initially got there, how things went, did he try to plan things out with you ahead of time? Did he give you any sort of heads up? Just gradually move into this sob fest that it is going to turn into, because you have broken my heart tonight, Laura.
I'm sorry that I did, but, and I know, like, when we talked earlier, you know, I cried, but I want nothing more than to go through the rest of my life and not cry anymore and not feel that what he did to me. I don't want to feel like a victim anymore. I tried to tell myself that I'm not a victim and that all I was a pawn. I was a pawn in Russ's bullshit. You know, I was a pawn into the media. I was a pawn, you know, for him to get ratings and money and whatever else he can get off of me. It was rough, but let's start from the beginning. So I flew into San Diego, California. When I got there, Russ and Carol immediately contacted me and said that I needed to meet them at this certain park in San Diego to do my my 3-hour waiver and NDA signing. We were there for about maybe 3.5-4 hours. I did it all, not knowing that the waiver and the NDA that I was signing was fake. At the time, Carol was a paralegal for a law firm, and I was then informed that Carol, being Russ's partner, wrote up the entire waiver and NDA. So it was all fake. I don't blame Carol at all. I mean, I still love Carol. After what she went through and I went through, we both realized that what she did was wrong in the beginning, because she was Russ's partner and she was living with him. And I mean, there's so much history between Russ and Carol that I don't feel it's my place to announce that, but that's on Carol. But what Russ put her through was pretty bad too. So I was at the hotel.
We can't hear you. I don't think we can hear you.
Can you hear me?
I think maybe you just covered up your mic piece for a second.
I don't even have a mic. I'm talking through my phone.
Maybe you covered up the little talking hole. I don't know.
I don't have a mic. I'm literally talking through my phone.
That was weird. Are you plotting? Are you scheming against me?
Can you hear me?
Yeah. I'm so sorry. Yeah, I'm weird. I should have warned you.
What?
I'm weird. I should have warned you ahead of time. Please continue. Ignore this. I'm sleepy.
I don't have a microphone. This is all coming live through me sitting here on my cell phone. Like, here I am. Here's my house. I'm just like, yay. So the day of my tour, I was at my hotel. It was a La Quinta, I think. Yeah, it was La Quinta. And Russ sent Carol over to my my hotel room to assure that a certain someone that I had met through McKay Minter online, that this particular person was not an actor and that he was just an online person, like that Russ and Carol and all the actors, I don't know, talk to throughout the years. But anyway, so the morning of my tour, I took an Imodium because I didn't want to shit myself from being scared. I also
fun facts, guys.
I did everything that I could to like not want to piss myself, shit myself, because I was truly scared. I really was. I didn't know what was going to happen. From what I thought was going to happen was like from like the past movies that Russ had made with his other actors and this and that. So the day of my waiver, my waiver and my NDA, once that was done, me, my husband, and Russ went to like these warehouses that Russ drove us to and told me that I was going to be in these warehouses, that there were going to be contraptions and things that I was going to go through, like going into a giant oven, and the oven was going to be turned on and I was going to have to find a way to get out. Also that I was going to be upside down in a water tank where eels, what are the manator eels, something like that, were going to be swimming around my head, and I had to figure out a way out. He also told me at the warehouse that I was going to be buried alive 12 feet under the ground, and I need to figure out a way out. I was also told that as I'm being buried underground, there was going to be a way for me to get out. Like there was going to be a light, and I had to figure out like some kind of combination to open the door, like the latch, for me to get out. I was psyched. I was so excited in the beginning. I guess I was kind of starstruck. You know, here I am, you know, in San Diego, California, with all these Facebook people watching me. And I didn't realize what was happening. I was never really into Facebook or any social media for that matter. And when I decided to go through Russ's shit or ridiculous haunt and lies and betrayal, at that time I thought it was real, and that I knew who I was, and I knew in my heart and soul that they weren't going to take me down. They just couldn't.
So I want to ask you, like,
who I am.
Like, just before you go too much further, like, I don't know how much of the stuff that you have seen, but so you've seen all the shows that we've done so far, like, with Surviving Life?
No, I haven't seen any of your shows. Again, I've really, since my tour, been really trying to not be in social media anymore.
Right.
It's just been really hard for me. So I really got out of it, but I have saved everywhere, every single solitary private message, every challenge, every solitary thing from 2016 until now. I have every solitary detail from every actor, from Ross, from everyone, Marissa, Jody, Angel, everyone. I have everything. I have it all. And I have it saved because I knew one day that I knew I was going to need it.
Well, that's fucking very, that is very interesting. We probably should have spoke about that beforehand. But so do you think that the, moving forward, so do you think that the Facebook fame, the all the people watching and all the hype, do you think that that plays a part in to how he gets people to come there? What is like part of the attraction of it itself? Because a lot of people ask, like, why do people want to do this shit to themselves? Why do people, and let alone come back multiple times? I mean, do you think that's just part of his mind game, that making people feel important on the internet kind of feeds into people's egos? Or what is your view, like, on how he attracts his quote unquote victims? We can't hear you. She's not. We can't hear you. We can't hear you again. We can't hear you. No.
Oh, wait. Now I hear you.
Yes. Okay.
Yes.
So repeat the past 5 minutes of your conversation.
Russ is by far one of the most manipulative men, even human being, that I've ever come across. I don't know if it's because he, you know, is in California and Hollywood and all the stuff. I mean, I know he's got a path.
We can't hear you again. We can't hear you.
You can't hear me?
I don't know what it is. It's like, I don't know what it's like. Are you like putting your finger over like the phone piece that you talk into? No. Maybe? That's no, so weird. I'm just holding my phone.
Can you hear me now?
Yes. I'm so sorry to, yes, I'm so sorry to keep interrupting you. I just want you to be heard and not just be this awkward, like, your mouth is moving, but nothing. Okay, so you're back. You're beautiful. Okay. We hear you.
You hear me now?
Yes.
It's like Verizon. Can you hear me now?
Can you hear me now?
I can hear you. yes, Russ is by far one of the most master manipulators of a human being that you will ever meet. He has the power to make you think and feel that he's your friend and that he's looking out for you and that, you know, he's a great guy. And that's what I thought. You know, I researched everything through all of McKamey Manor before I went through my tour. I watched all the movies, all the videos. I dug really deep. And when it came down to October of 2016, it was different. Like before 2016, like the act or the contestants were never told to do challenges or anything like that. It was just like from the beginning of I guess like maybe the end of September and all of October is when he started having the contestants such as myself do challenges. There was me, Pamela Van Hill, Marissa Phillips, Jodie Foster, Angel DeVille, Patrick. There was a lot of people. Who was the other one? What was her name? She was also one. I'll get you her name. I'm having a brain fart over it, but
it wasn't Christina Buster, was it?
Shit show. What?
It wasn't Christina Buster.
No, Christina Buster was not in the October tour. No.
Okay. That was just a comment I seen popped up. I figured I would.
No, Christina was not in our tour. She was she was going through McKamey Manor way before I even knew what it was. She was through his tours through, like, you know, the very early years of 2000. And, you know, she was a powerhouse. I mean, I have nothing but respect for Christina Buster and what she went through. But towards the end, when she went back through again after everything that happened to me and Angel and everyone else, she went back in again, and what they did to her was, it was pretty raw. It was pretty bad. You know, they were dragging her by her feet along a curb. But nothing that happened to Christina was worse than what they did to me. There is no one in McKamey Manor history that ever went through what I went through. None of them suffered broken bones, lost their job. Their face was disfigured. I got scars all over me that I can't get rid of unless I get them covered up with tattoos, which I'm now doing. I was the very first person. Go ahead, what?
No, I know you shared some photos with me earlier. Like, I literally thought you got shot in the leg with a 9mm. Like, literally, that shit was fucked. Absolutely fucked.
Yeah, it was pretty bad. They did fracture the top of my left foot. I couldn't walk. I couldn't put shoes on for like 4 months on my left foot. They fucked me up pretty good. You know, pardon my French, but yeah, they got me pretty good. My left knee, I did have a previous injury because I was training. Sorry. Oops. I was training, physically to be able to handle what I was going to handle. And, Lindsay, oh my God, you have permanent scars. Yes, Susie Q. We're getting a lot of messages over here, Josh.
There's 80-something messages I've paid no attention to because I'm literally just paying attention to you right now. So we can do this later.
Yeah, I did have a minor previous injury on my left knee. As I was training physically, I did slip.
Whoa. Why am I by myself?
She disconnected, probably technical issues.
Oh no.
That's not good.
Nah. Let me cut my stuff on and or off and get her back in here.
Here she is. Unless
you're ready to go to. Okay, cool.
Hey. Am I back?
Yes.
Sorry. There it is. I was training and I did slip. Doing a lot of hiking and climbing up mountains because I live here in Colorado, and I love physical activity. And I just slipped and I hurt my knee, but it was healed by the time of my tour. That wound on my knee that you saw was from them making me drag my knees across the ground. From my, it's like, doggy style, whatever, your hands are front and they're making me crawl, against the pavement on my knees, and my knee just eventually just gave out. I was bleeding a lot. I begged and pleaded, please just, I can't bend on my left knee anymore. I can't. And then they just kept screaming at me and telling me, to move my ass, keep going. And
so was it more so the actors yelling at you, or was it Russ yelling at them?
Everyone. It was the actors. It was Russ. It was everybody. There were so many voices around me. I had 4 male actors in my tour, along with 2 women, along with Russ. And so there was 6-7 people screaming at me, telling me do this, do that, as they're hitting me and pushing me and hurting me. And so eventually my left leg, I had to kind of put behind me, and I used my hands and my right knee to drag myself forward. I couldn't go on my left knee anymore. It was bad. When they fractured my foot, that was inside the van. I was told at the very beginning of my tour that me being inside the van would only last about 30 to 45 minutes. And then they were, I'm seeing these messages and I can't read them fast enough and respond. when I was in the van, oh God, I remember everything. I remember absolutely everything.
And hey, before you get into this, I know how emotional you're getting ready to get. So if you need to take a break and cut your camera off, or whatever you need, do what you need to do. Really.
Thank you. I'm okay. You know, I have my crying bouts and a little bit of hysteria here and there, but I'm okay. I have come to a point in my life that people, I think, really need to know my story and what really happened to me inside that van and outside that van. I think it's time that I open up, and I really want to begin to trust again. I've lost all trust in all of humanity. To me, everyone is out to get me. Everyone is lying and deceitful and just horrible people. And I was never like that before this. I had these bright eyes and just this glow about me back then that I loved being around people, and I loved talking to people, and I just loved everything. And then after that, what Russ and his monsters did to me, I lost everything. I lost all faith in humanity. Like, I don't trust anybody. And Josh, you are by far one of the first people to know, like, how big of trust issues that I really have.
Well, just before you go further, I think everybody in this chat can agree you still have a glow. Look at that smile. Look at it. You don't have a glow? Shh. Anyways, go ahead.
Well, thank you. I am really trying so hard in my life to, you know, move on from what happened and, you know, try and get a better grasp of my life and my future. And I believe I really have. I've worked very, very hard to move on, and I've got a great job. I've got a great life. I'm happy. I smile a lot now, but even still, like, there's like a part of me that I hope that I will recover from, but inside of me and in my soul, I don't think I ever will, unless I see Russ McKamey in prison for the rest of his life. And I'd also like to see the actor that did this to me also pay the penalty of what they did. It wasn't just Russ, but it was the actors too. Russ didn't, you know, ordered them to do what they did to me, but they are adults, they're human beings, and they should have known when enough was enough, but they didn't. They just kept hitting me, beating me, cow prodding me, tasering me, waterboarding me, punching me in my face over and over and over again, which, Josh, I know you have my pictures. I was scalped. The things that happened to me inside there, I don't know if there's a person out there that could survive from that, unless, you know, you were in the military and you were in the war. I was legitimately tortured. I've even talked to men that actually were in like the military and through Afghanistan and what they went through. And I've shared my story with them, even though I was not military. But when I told my story to them, they even told me that they even never went through or saw what I went through. And that's pretty fucked up, especially, you know, during the war. I just want my soul to heal. I really want to just move on emotionally and mentally. And I just finally want to heal. Granted, physically, yes, I healed, but emotionally, mentally, and in my heart and soul, I don't think I ever will, until I know that Russ McKamey and all of his shit fuck actors pay for what they did to me. And that's Ryan Lawrence, Beth Hipple, Lindsay Boley, Nick Baldwin, Chris, who's known as Pedro. I will get his last name soon. Mike Meekum, especially Mike. Russ McCamey. I want them all to go down. I'm done. You know, I'm not going to be quiet anymore. I was quiet for a long time, and I'm done. I want to heal, and the only way I can is when I know that these monsters and what they did to me and what Russ ordered them to do to me pay for what they did. I don't want revenge. I just want justice. That's it. I don't want them hurt. I don't want them to go through what I went through. I just want justice. And I want what they did to me.
I think you cover your. We can't hear you again.
Can you hear me? Oh, can you hear me now?
Gotcha.
Can you hear me now? Sorry, I think I keep putting my finger on my phone. Anyway, what did you miss?
It was just literally the very last two sentences we did not hear.
The last two sentences is that the only way for my heart and soul to ever heal and ever where I can finally be whole again is for Russ McCamey and all his actors such as Beth Hipple, Lindsay Boley, Ryan Lawrence, Mike Meekum, Chris, I will get you his last name. He goes by Pedro. Russ McCamey, I want them all. I want justice for myself. I don't ever want them to be hurt, but I want justice. I think each and every one of them deserve to be in prison. it was so funny. Once my tour ended and things started going on, even like that first year of my tour, I did go to the police. I did go to the authorities, even in California. Detective Shepard, he was on Russ's payroll. So Detective Shepard just blew me off, you know, didn't do anything. No one helped me. I was all by myself forever. No one helped me. I did it all. And it was scary. But I want them to pay. I want justice. I don't want them hurt. I just want justice. Mike Meekum even contacted me many times, begging and pleading to me, don't go to the authorities because Mike Meekum in California is a two-strike offender. The third strike, he goes to prison. And I'm fine with that. Actually, I want him to go to prison. And I hope whatever I say and whatever I can do through what you and Ron and everyone is doing that I want him to go to prison for what he did because Mike is one of the most important actors in my tour and what he did. I am very aware of when I was getting hit and punched in my face over and over that was Nick Baldwin. I know everything. I am a bundle of information of what these fuckers did to me. And I want justice. I don't want revenge. I just want justice. You know, I don't want to see anyone else hurt. I don't want an innocent person to go through what I went through in Russ's shit show of a haunt. It's not a haunt. It's personal to Russ. And that's all it is. It's all personal. He likes to see people in pain. That's what he likes. But what Russ didn't realize when I came aboard is that I don't break very easily. I just don't. He thought I was, even on the day of my tour when the media was there and my husband was there, Russ had asked my husband, Jeremy, how long do you think your wife is going to last? And Jeremy looked at Russ and he actually kind of smiled and laughed because my husband of 20 years knows exactly what I'm capable of and what I'm not. And Russ told Jeremy, he's like, excuse me, he's like, I think your wife is going to last like 2 minutes. And Jeremy looked at Ross and said, you have no idea.
He don't know shit about Chirac.
And there we go. I don't think Russ really was prepared for me and what I'm about. I've been through a lot in my entire life. I grew up Southside Chicago. I've seen it all. I've done it all. I wasn't going to break. There was no way. And I wasn't doing it for fame. I wasn't doing it for, you know, let's beat the next contest. I wasn't doing any of that. I did it. I went through this tour because I personally was going through something emotionally that I needed to get out of me. Like I had like this beast kind of feeling inside of me that I needed to get out. And I thought that was my escape and that was what was going to help me be free. And it turned out that it just turned out the opposite. What I thought I was getting into was not what happened. Again, my tour was personal. Russ took it personal. And now I'm taking it personal. And now this is why I'm coming out.
Well, I can assure you, together with all of us, we're going to kick his fucking ass and we're going to kick all his actors' fucking asses. So I, Jesus Christ. So, first of all, I love you so much. Like, I'm not the only one with facial expressions anymore. It's the greatest thing. I'm so glad you've not seen any of the other videos because people roast me because I have the most extravagant facial fucking expressions. And shout out to you to keeping me up until, what is it now, 3:30 in the morning for two nights in a row.
See, by me, it's only 1:30.
Yeah, lucky you. Lucky you. So, I don't want to dig into too, I don't want to dig too deep into your stuff, but I do for myself because I'm greedy. But I just don't want you to have to relive this twice because I know that you're going to do Ron's show as well. And I don't want to take anything away from him. And I don't want to have people like not come back because they've already heard it. But your shit is just so not only interesting, but like I'm literally going to cry myself to sleep. Like,
like I don't want anyone to cry. I've done enough crying in my life for everybody. All I want right now is for at this moment, I just want everyone to realize that everything I've said from 2016, what happened to me has been nothing but the truth. I've like, what was it like? And it was like, even in 2017, people were spreading rumors that I beat my own self up like that. That I did it to myself, and that
would be extremely fucking hard. First,
yeah,
extremely
fucking. You know, I just love beating my ass so bad that I look like a pumpkin.
if you did that to yourself, props.
Everything. What?
If you did that to yourself, props. You deserve a fucking Golden Globe.
Shit! If I did that to myself, I deserve to be on a Rob Zombie movie.
No fucking shit. You'll be on the floor from hell next year. So.
Right? No, I did not do this to myself. How long did her tour last?
Good question, right?
Hello, Heather. My tour started at about 12:30 in the afternoon, and I did not get back to my hotel until about 5 o'clock. So you do the math. I did not hang out with them afterwards. Immediately as they let me free, my husband took me in the rental car that we had. I went straight back to my hotel and I got there at 5. Russ said that my tour only lasted an hour and 55 minutes. But again, it started about 12:30. I had met with Russ, Beth, and Lindsay to do a drug test, which was, by the way, fake. That only lasted a few minutes. Shortly after that, yeah, it just happened. It happened fast. So for Russ to say that I only lasted an hour and 55 minutes, again, do the math. I got there at 12:30 and I didn't get back to my hotel until 5.
Funny how that McCamey Manor time frame works in that dude's brain. I mean, it's still to this day, it's just like you sit there for 6 hours and then your time doesn't start until you get inside the manor. So
I got a question here. Lori, have you or are you willing to consider a civil lawsuit against Russ? You've got a strong case if you want it. You deserve justice, even if it's a civil win and not criminal. I did, in fact, go to the police. I had spoken with San Diego Police Department, and I spoke with a Detective Shepherd. And I did want to file not only a civil complaint, but criminal and a physical assault. Unfortunately, this Detective Shepherd through San Diego Police Department was on Russ's payroll. And anyone that went through McKamey Manor and got hurt that went to the police dealt with Detective Shepherd. And Detective Shepherd made sure that he didn't do anything. He made sure that we all were quiet, and you know, he dismissed us. He was a fucking joke. I am past civil. I don't want to go after him civilly. I want this man to be in prison. I want him.
Yeah, we're way past that point.
We're way past civil. This is way beyond that. What I want is what I deserve, and that's real justice, not revenge. Again, just real justice. And it's not even just Russ. It's Mike and Ryan and Chris and Beth and Lindsay and just everyone else that was involved. It's beyond that. Like, I think the FBI should be involved, and I think all of these people should be taken down.
So this might be a toughy one for you. This is real.
Nothing's tougher than what I've been through, so throw it at me.
How dare you do that to me? So first of all, like, there is a certain group of people that think that, you know, the actors were brainwashed into thinking that this was all okay, that this was all legal, that, I know you got something to say to those people, so I just want to let you say your piece to those people that think that the actors were just brainwashed and they thought this was just all in good fun.
I do not believe that the actors were brainwashed by any means. Again, watching all the past movies that they have done with Russ over the years, was different than what they did to me. I think with me and doing everything that I did, online, live, through my tour, I think maybe Russ wanted them to, I don't know. I don't think that they were brainwashed, no. I do know, though, was it the actors weren't in the old videos? And yes, all the actors were in all his old movies. I can name every single one of them. Anyway, I think what happened to me, I don't know, like, when it came down to Russ finding out that I smoke pot, big fucking deal. I live in Colorado. It's legal. It's legal all over the fucking country.
It's not even legal where I live, and I'll light the shit up right now.
Me too. I think when Russ found out that I did get involved with Jimmy Murchill, it was just an online innocent, I needed somebody. When I just needed somebody to listen to me, and he did. And Jimmy was great for a while, but he turned out to be a fucking piece of shit, you know, like everyone else. But when Russ found out that Jimmy and I were talking, Russ, from what I understand and what I was told, oh shit. Cheers. Hold on.
I forgot. Here, I'll double up.
Cheers. From what I understand, his San Diego hunt has two different timelines. 2008 was a touch boo hunt with kid actors, including me. I don't know who this is, but
it's the guy on the video with us.
Yeah. Anyway, let's move forward for a second, and then I'll get into the van and what happened. Shit, where were we?
I don't remember. We were drinking something and You were talking about. Oh, fuck. What were you talking about? Someone comment and remind us what we were talking about because
I
I
know the
also
comment,
got
like the
distracted.
person that thinks it
Yeah.
distracted me.
I got so into that comment because it was so long, it completely brain farted me. And like my dog's in there whining, wanting to go outside. Actually, can you give me like 2 minutes? Are you comfortable enough to do like a Q&A from the chat long enough for me to let my dog go pee and cut my camera off? And then I'll
Absolutely.
be right back. Okay.
Absolutely. I'm an open book. I will
Okay,
answer any and every question.
I just didn't want to make you uncomfortable, so I'm gonna keep my
No,
wait.
I'm okay. I'm okay.
Okay.
But more importantly, your doggy's got to go potty.
Yes, because if he pees on my floor, we's gonna have the problem. So I'm gonna cut
Have
my
a
camera
dog
on.
too, I understand.
I have a little pit bull mix, and he is the cutest thing on God's green earth. Or
Oh, I know,
whose
mine
ever
is too. I
green
have
earth
a
it is.
Rottweiler Pitbull lab mix. You want to see my
Ah,
dog? Would you
yes.
like to see my dog?
Everyone wants to see your dog. Everyone needs to
Okay.
see your dog right now.
All right, here we go. Harley. Harley. Right. Where's your face?
Yes. It
Harley.
is the most beautiful thing I've ever seen.
Harley, hold on. Harley. Shit. Okay, hold on. Where are you? I'm trying to like move the camera for him, for you to see him. But he's all black and come here, Harley. Harley.
The suspense is killing me. Where's the dog? Oh, look it.
My doggy.
This is exactly what this entire YouTube, whoever, wherever the fuck platform you're watching this, it's exactly what we needed tonight. So I'm gonna let my dog go drain his old lizard there, and I'll be back. Hopefully things don't unravel, but I'll have my headphones on. And if you need to ask me anything, I can talk. And
And
you
yes,
have
Harley
covered up
is
your
my
microphone.
furby.
Okay.
Do you have any questions for me?
By the way, we
By
can't hear you.
the way, can hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you now. I was just
Okay.
letting you know.
Yes, Russ did make a big deal about me smoking pot. But the only reason that he found out that I was smoking pot is because Marissa Phillips told him that I did, and she had even said that, it was just like to mind fuck me. But what she didn't realize is what she told him was part of the reason of what happened to me. Even before my tour, I stopped smoking pot about 5 weeks beforehand, and I've even taken a home drug test through like head shops and even at my job, and I was clean. So when they did, when I the day of my tour, when they wanted to drug test me, they said that they heard, that it was dirty, whatever. There was no actual drug test. It was me, Lindsay Boley, and Beth Hipple in a 7-Eleven bathroom, and they grabbed a test tube for me to pee in. I mean, before my tour, man, I took an Imodium. I peed as much as I possibly could so that during my tour, I didn't have to worry about like my bowel movements, I guess. I was very prepared. So when we were in the 7-Eleven bathroom and, they gave me this little tiny test tube, I mean, I think I maybe was able to urinate, I don't know, like a quarter of the test tube. And then when we walked out of the 7-Eleven, the right next to that was a Spirit Halloween store. And they pretended to do a drug test, which I found out later on was fake. There was actually no drug test. And they lied to me the entire time. And then Russ told me that the only way that I would ever be able to go through a tour is either A, I drink my own urine, or B, I'm done. He's like, thank you for coming to California. Thank you for coming to San Diego. But if you don't drink your shit, yes, I did really drink my own pee inside the van. Yes. They made me do it. I told Russ that I have come so far and I've done so much, including being the very first person to ever get a McKamey Manor tattoo on me. Yeah, I was willing to do whatever it took, and I did. I caught this late, so I don't know if you addressed this yet, but did you believe Russ ever drugged anyone orally or via? No, I do not believe Russ drugged anyone. I do not. I believe he manipulated people to think that he did. Me personally, I was never drugged. I was aware and conscious of every single solitary thing that ever happened to me. Even at the end, you know, one of the actors, Chris, told me, he's like, yeah, we hit in your face so many times. He goes, you passed out. I said, I didn't pass out. I was just numb. That's what I was. I was numb. I felt everything. I knew every fucking thing that happened to me. But I wasn't going to be like some squealing fucking pig saying, oh God, no, I was numb. I took it all and I'm still taking it all. And now it's my time to let Russ take it all. What I did, what he put me through. There was a, why did the detective say he wasn't willing to pursue? Detective Shepard was on Russ's payroll. Russ paid Detective Shepard to keep us all quiet. There had been many people that went to the San Diego Police Department that dealt with Detective Shepard that he just dismissed. Again, that detective was a piece of fucking shit. It makes me sad to believe that this man is in law enforcement and was on Russ's side after what he was doing to people, especially myself. Were the hits full force? Yes, the hits were full force in my face. My face was swollen so much like a pumpkin that I could barely talk for about 4 days. I was straw fed with liquids and food because I couldn't open my mouth. My nose was severely sprained. Even when I went into the ER, they thought it was a little fractured, along with my left foot was fractured. Yeah, it was bad. What was the worst part of your tour for you? The worst part of my tour for me was, I guess, all of it. Being lied to was honestly the worst. Being manipulated was the worst. Being told that, you know, I was only going to be in the van for 30 to 45 minutes and then I was going to go to the warehouses. It was all deceit, and that broke me. It really hurt me. I was in that van for so long that eventually they ran out of things to do to me. I even remember being in the van and the actors telling Russ, and they called them boss. The actor said, boss, we don't even know what else to do with her. Like, she just won't quit. And Russ said to them, go harder, beat her harder. And they did. They still didn't quit. I don't think there was one particular part that was worse than the other, with the exception to the lies and the deceit and just what they honestly did. You know, I'm a strong person and I can handle a lot of physical contact and whatever. I mean, I'm a strong bitch myself, and I don't care who you are, male or female, I will take you on anytime. But in this case, I was told that I had to be completely submissive, and I did. And now looking back, I wish I didn't follow Russ's rules, and I wish I would have stuck to my own gut. And as they were doing this and hitting me and beating me and cow prodding me and tasering me and waterboarding me, I wish I would have. Can you put your exit interview into context? I'm not sure. I'll try. I haven't seen my exit video online or anything like that, but I do know in my exit video that when I did it before Russ put the cameras on, Russ did threaten me and tell me that I needed to say all these amazing things about McKamey Manor in my experience. And hold on, I gotta do a toast. Hold on.
I just know how wicked this is about to get. So
it's gonna get wicked. Cheers, babe.
Yeah.
Cheers.
I do know that in my exit video, Russ did threaten me a $50,000 that if I didn't say great things about McKamey Manor and my tour, that yeah, he'd sue me. So he made me lie on my exit video saying that what happened to me was exhilarating and it was great and blah, blah, blah. I mean,
I can't imagine what the fuck that did to you. Like, I can't imagine what that did to you mentally, like trying to publicly condone some bullshit like that that was done to you. Like, I cannot imagine the fucking situation that put you in.
It was really fucked up. Because I don't lie. Oh, did he waterboard you? Wait, did he waterboard you? You're so strong, Lori. We love you. Yes, I was waterboarded many, many times to the point where I did actually a couple times through my tour think that I was going to stop breathing and I literally was going to die. But I was so mentally strong that I wasn't going to let them break me. I just wasn't. And again, on my exit video, Russ made me say how exhilarating my tour was and how great it was. And oh my God, I'm going to do it again. Yeah. Fuck you, Russ. You know, all it was lies. It was all lies, deceit. And again, Russ kept telling me that he was going to sue me for $50,000, whether it be like my exit video, my NDA, and the waiver. I was going to be sued. And then it wasn't even until after my tour, maybe like a few months later, where me and Christina George got to be good friends, and she confirmed it that the waiver, the NDA, and everything was a fake at that time. And I don't want to call her out because now going, like moving forward, she's a very wonderful woman that went through a lot of shit with Russ too. But at that time, when the NDA and the waiver was made, Carol wrote it. Carol Schultz wrote it. She was a paralegal through a law firm. The whole thing was a fake. It was all a lie. I will never in a million years ever not like Carol or blame her for anything. I won't. I absolutely adore Carol. Carol, if you're hearing me right now, I don't know what to say. Like, I don't know what to say. I'm just glad that you got away from that monster and I was able to help you do that. Angel actually saved Carol and packed up all her shit in San Diego. And they went from San Diego and traveled all the way through Denver, where I got to actually meet Angel DeVille for the first time and spend some time with Carol at their hotel with all the dogs. And I don't know.
Them some cute dogs.
I have a really great amount of respect for Carol and what she went through. And I love you, Carol. And thank you for being there for me. And I do forgive you for the deceit that you did do to me through McKamey Manor. But I forgive you. The waiver is just used for mind games. He does it to get into your head to try and bring people down. You're a strong woman, and I'm glad that you didn't break to his bullshit. Thank you so, so much. That really means a lot to me. I just knew that I have to be me. I have to be real, and I know who I am. I know where I come from, and I know that there was nothing that was going to break me, especially Russ and his fucking antics and his bullshit. I proved to him that I am a beast, and what he got with me, he had no idea what was coming for him. And I don't think he still knows, but here I am, and I'm back, and Russ became me. If you're seeing this and you hear me, it's on, bitch. Fuck you. What you did to me is unforgivable, and what I'm going to do to you, for me, will be forgivable. Did Russ ever try to contact you at all after returning? Yes, Russ did try and contact me a lot. We talked for a little bit. And then when Russ knew that what happened to me was coming out, where I decided to come clean and tell the truth, and I didn't give a fuck about his NDA or his waiver or anything else. I didn't fucking care. I knew what happened to me was wrong. And so, yes, he did try and contact me a couple times. It didn't go over too well. And then Russ immediately blocked me from all of his groups. And he had, MMT or MMR, whatever, all the hate groups, they were all against me. But Russ knew when I finally was coming out with everything that happened to me, he made sure that every single solitary person that ever had anything to do with McKamey Manor would be against me. They called me a liar. They told me I did this to myself, that I beat myself up. He did everything he could to try and break me again. And I ain't having it. I won't be broken. I wasn't broken then. I'm not going to be broken now. So Russ McKamey, if you're hearing this, go fuck yourself, you little fucking cunt, because I'm coming for you and I'm gunning for you. And you will go to prison for what you did to me. Fuck you.
And I can personally guarantee you, well, maybe 98% of every motherfucker watching this right now has got your back. So if you decide to watch this back and look at the comments, I can guarantee you it's pretty much nothing but love, and you have all the support in the world. We can't hear you. We can't hear you.
What? Oh, sorry. Sorry. Yes, Lindsay. Russ is absolutely delusional. I don't know if it's what happened in the Navy, but Russ had even told me that when he was in the Navy and they were on the ships, that they would do this kind of thing even on the ships. Like, Russ has been doing this for so long that he is such a mastermind of lies and deceit. He can make anyone believe that, if you don't like potatoes, he'll make you believe that you like potatoes, and he'll make you eat them and that you'll love them. That's the way he is. The devil himself. Yes, he is a devil.
So what do you think? What do you think he gets out of this? I mean, why does he do this? Why does he make people do this? Why did he make people do this to others? And why do you think he's completely changed ass backwards to where people are calling him a phony now, that he's literally not doing anything besides front yard bullshit? I mean, what is your opinion on this fucker's mentality? I need to know from you.
Russ's mentality is like, he thinks he's Hollywood fame. He thinks he is above and beyond everything. What some people don't actually know about Russ is that he does actually have a mental disability. He even was in the hospital and had brain surgery. I don't know if y'all knew that, but yeah, he did. I have pictures on that too.
By the way, Susie Q,
thank you. Thank you everybody for supporting me and like being there for me. It's been 3 years since my tour, and I really wish that y'all were here right after that. But again, going back to Russ's mentality, I think Russ likes to do this to people because he's a control freak. He likes to be in control of everything. And when he's not in control, he will do whatever it takes to be in control. Russ is so mentally fucked up that I don't even think the best psychiatrist in the world could ever dig deep inside of Russ McKamey's brain. Again, he's been doing this forever. He fucked over everybody. He doesn't care about what happens to people. He just doesn't care. He doesn't care about people hurting. He doesn't care about pain. All he cares about, I think he's taking... yes, I do believe that he's taking out his mental issues on others. He's so delusional that I don't think he even realizes how severely mentally ill he really is. And maybe prison is not the answer for Ross. Maybe like psychiatric unit is something for Ross. I don't know.
A padded fucking room. Okay.
Yes. Yes. Definitely a white padded room where he can like bang his head up and do whatever. I don't wish any harm on anybody. Again, all I want is just justice for what happened to me. You know, I want to see them all in prison. I don't want to see anyone beat or hurt or disfigured the way they did to me. I'm not that kind of person that wants, I don't want revenge. I just want justice. I want justice as to what happened to me, as well as Christina Buster and Angel I want justice for all of us through October. Even Patrick, as far as Marissa Phillips, Marissa, if you're watching this right now, you better run. You better run and hide really good, because you live in Colorado Springs, sweetheart, just as you are only 45 minutes away from me. I will always be looking for you, and I will find you. And when I do, I will get my justice too. Thanks, Marissa. You've only given me empowerment to get my justice. And you are a big part of it. You are the reason, one of the reasons that this happened to me. I don't think you're going to get away that easy. Hide, bitch. Hide. Hide. No, Marissa was not an actor. Marissa was a contestant. And she was one of the contestants. She was at the end of September. And Marissa told Ross that she would suck his dick in order to get her tour not be hard on her. She wanted to be easy on her. And that's what they did. She sucked Russ's dick, from what I understand. And if you look at the end of her tour, and I'll show you a picture of her, she had a little tiny scratch right here above her nose. Nothing more, nothing less. Her fucking hair wasn't cut. She lied to the whole fucking thing. No, Marissa was not an actor. She's nothing but a piece of shit, fucking pathetic excuse for a fucking human. She's not even human. She's just a pathetic excuse for fucking trash. And I'm going to make sure I tell that she knows I know she's trash. Because I'm gunning for her.
Well, it's a very good thing for you that we are on a platform to where nobody gives a fuck what you say. Because maybe or maybe not, that would not have flown on YouTube, but your boy don't give a shit. That was interesting as fuck. And I'm here to hear everybody's side of the story, because I know I elaborated to you earlier that, you know, I had heard Marissa out. She made me physically cry. Like, I felt so deeply for her. So, in the bottom of my heart, I do hope this is some kind of really fucked up misunderstanding and somehow you two come together to some peace. Obviously, it doesn't seem like that's going to happen. But, fuck. That was spicy and, fuck.
That's, I will never let go of what Marissa did to me. She acted, she pretended to be my friend. She pretended to be on my side. She made me believe that she was a good person. But yet, all along, she was the one that orchestrated what happened to me. She was the one that told Rust that, oh, she doesn't smoke pot. She doesn't do anything. She's so innocent. Yet she dogged me out to Rust. So what if I fucking smoke pot? Shit. Pot is legal, man. Fucking get with the ages. Shit, I live in Colorado, bro.
We got our own holiday, bro.
I think that's what I want to do. I'm going to go smoke a bowl right now. I'm gonna...
Oh, no. Okay, age on, restriction on YouTube coming right now at this point in the video. you're turning the fuck up, apparently.
Wait, I found it. All right, now okay. I need to find it later. Hold on.
Yeah, what? So I'm just going to, for my own well-being, I'm just going to toast.
What are you gonna do?
I'm just gonna toast because we'll do like a post live thing.
I'm gonna
toast
you too in a second. Okay, I'm gonna try and do this and hold my phone at the same time. Josh wants to get
drunk.
Josh wants to get drunk. So why?
Okay,
fuck.
If you after deal what with I've the been shit through, that
we deserve to get drunk. So, all right, hold on. I'm gonna try and place my phone. This. Let's see. Hold on. Oh, I need something. What can I? Ooh, okay, I got it.
Adult content, beware.
Hold on. I'm trying
so
to.
So we are just officially.
Or it doesn't fall down.
I think me and you are just the party squad now. I think we are just.
Okay, so I'm going to do this. I'm going to do this. Ready? All right, my phone is kind of between my knees. Hey, Ross. You ready?
Aye. This is really happening right now.
Hey, Russ.
I hope we didn't just get banned from our platforms. I just want to say.
Josh, here's to you, bro.
No shit. Oh, gosh. I can't just double like that. Come on, you can't put me on the spot. We have people watching us. So now I'm supposed to drink a little bit more of this and cover up for the, you know what? Elaborate.
Not like YouTube gonna check this out. Laugh my ass off. Plus, that's legal. I don't know why you guys are talking about legal, illegal. Right? I live in Colorado. Pot is legal. Pot is legal almost throughout the whole country. Give me a fucking break. You know, for those of you that fucking got some shit to say about, you know, a weed and whatever, you know, get a grip. Get a grip. It's 2000 and almost 20. You know, we all smoke pot. Well, maybe not everyone, but, you know.
Smoke that ganja.
Yeah, I will smoke the ganja. Oh,
I just gotta say,
you know, I'm not a drug addict. I don't do all those fucking stupid drugs like heroin and crack and meth and whatever. You know, I'm a pothead and I like to drink my wine. And yes, of course, I do like to drink maybe a little bit of whiskey and a little bit of vodka. What are you drinking, Josh?
Proper fucking 12.
Wait, what are you drinking?
Proper 12. The best Irish.
Have you ever done a psychedelic? So I've got this question that someone has asked me, have you ever done a psychedelic? Well, yeah,
I'm not sure why that fucking matters, first of all, but
well,
cool.
Of course, in my 20s, yeah, you know, I had a really good time. You know, I've eaten shrooms, whatever. I'm from the 70s and 80s. I'm not this new fucking generation that's like so prima donna and just out of control. You know, I'm an old school cat and, you know, I don't know, call me a hippie, call me whatever, but you know, yeah, I've done a lot of fun stuff, but I never hurt anyone in the process. So maybe we can move on from, like, you know, the drugs I've done in my past, and we can maybe go back to where we are today. Thank you.
Yeah, so
psychedelics are common now for this new age, and I'm sure they are. That's great, but I'm sure they are, but this is not what this is about. This show is not about, you know, psychedelics or anything. This show is about what happened to me in McKamey Manor, and I'd like to keep it that way.
The beast. So yeah, let's bring the shit back on topic.
Thank you.
I guess I just need to retake control of the comment. So
you're right there, Josh.
Yeah, I'm just talking to you before this and talking to you during this, and it's just, it is 4:02 in the morning. My hair is down. I got my Dwight Schrute PJ shirt on, eyes ready for bed. So I just want to cover on, like, we went through in minuscule detail. I know we did not go into detail into what happened to you, because I don't want you to go into more detail than that more times than you have to. You gave that to me, and I know you're going to do it for Ron when he asks you. So I don't want you to have to relive that more than you have to. You've already done that for me. And these people watching this are going to see it again when you do it with Ron. So don't put yourself through that again, because I see how emotional you get, and I know how hard it is. So let's just move on to post-tour. How are you feeling? Like, how did it end? What was what broke you? And just the after effects. And I guess I got a couple questions after we get through this. We'll handle that at the very end, because we're pushing 2 hours somehow. We have been on here for 2 hours almost. Can you believe that?
I know. Yeah.
You brave woman.
Thank you. Thank you. That means a lot to me. Even after my tour, what they did to continue tormenting me, I don't even know what to say. Even after what happened, I had hundreds of thousands of people calling me a liar, calling me a fake, telling me that I did this to myself. I don't know. It's kind of mind-boggling to me that when I even posted all my pictures, that people still thought I was lying. I don't know. It did something to me. That
I'm sorry to interrupt you, but if anybody called you a liar after you posted them goddamn pictures, fuck them motherfuckers. 100% fuck them motherfuckers.
Yeah. It was pretty bad. I even at like one of the apartments that I was living in, when I did my tour, I had received death threats. It got to a point where I even had like I don't know, like computer paper, where they would write, "You're gonna die. Fuck you. You're lying ass bitch. McKamey Manor fucking rules." They were posting this on my door. It got to a point. It just got so fucking bad that I moved somewhere else. And I, at that point where I moved, where I am now, is when I decided I'm not going to be in social media anymore. I'm just going to go away. And I tried to just go away. Lori, we absolutely believe you and we support you. We say, thank you so very much, Lindsay. That really means a lot to me. All the support that I'm getting now is like mind blowing to me, because I really needed it back then and I didn't get it. And it's,
I think you muted your mic. I think your
but before you go, I have my mic muted. I'm just trying to tell you something. The Lindsay Girls comment that you just read, the group that I told you about that I have, she's one of the moderators. So if you ever want to reach out to a female and feel confident that nothing will be talked about outside of your conversation, she will be one of the people that will abide by that, and I can vouch for that.
That's awesome, and I think for someone. But Josh, as you know, there may be a big step coming for me as far as becoming a manor. I'm not going to disclose what may be coming, but it's going to be big. It's going to be, yeah. I hope this happens. I really do. Because toast. If...
well, <anyway. laughs> Cheers. Toast to the big Wait. News that will never be revealed until it's too late.
The big surprise that I hope would happen, and I'm not going to disclose any of that, but I will have more details tomorrow, and again, I have nothing but surprises.
You have just been an absolute bundle of fucking joy. So I don't understand. Like, I just need to put Miss Lori here in perspective for everyone watching.
Literally, and thank you for calling me Lori.
Yes. We need to make this known for the masses. Her name is not Laura. It is Lori with an E. You don't L-E-U-R-I-T. Have permission to call her Laura. Yes.
Only my mom and dad call me Laura, and that was always when I was in trouble, which was almost like 99% of the time. But yeah, I don't go by Laura. It's Lori. Please. Thank you.
Shots fired to anybody who says otherwise. So, oh my God, you have completely gave me a brain fart. Oh, yes. So, I was calling you out for what you did to me, bad woman. You, 20 minutes before this phone call, these poor people were waiting on us, and you had me crying and so sad, and you come on here, and you're smiling, and you just, you handled this so well, and I'm so proud of you. You got so much shit out. And you did not shed one single fucking tear. You are probably the strongest and most bravest woman I have seen on the internet in the past decade. So, and you have hundreds and thousands of people going to have your back by the end of this. I do wholeheartedly believe that the outcome that you want is going to be achieved. And if I have anything to do with it, those fuckers will rot in hell, not only a prison cell, for the shit that they did to you and many other fucking people. So, I got your back no matter what. And all these people in this chat have your fucking back. Don't ever feel bad or feel guilty or feel like you're responsible for what happened to you, because you are not responsible for what happened to you.
Oh, I know that. You did not deserve that shit. I know I'm not responsible. I mean, I signed up for, just an extreme haunt because, Lori, just know that whatever karma may come. Yes, I do believe that karma will get Russ. I do. Thank you. All I wanted was to, endeavor in something other than, stupid little haunted houses. They just didn't do it for me. And then when I did my research on McKinney Manor and I saw all the movies and everything, I had no idea that hell was literally going to rain on me and tear me apart and make me be someone that I didn't want to be. I've always been hopeful. I've always been, trustworthy, and I do trust in people. I believe that. I used to believe that, when I meet people and they tell me things that I can trust them, and Russ and his fucking monsters, they took my soul away. They didn't just beat me and torment me and torture me. Like they took something out of my body, out of my soul that I don't know, which I really hope one day that I can get back. Because
you will get it back.
I can get my tattoo, my McKayman Matter tattoo covered up. I can do everything, but I just want my peace of mind and my heart and my soul healed. I'm sorry, I don't mean to cry.
No, like you, if you need,
I just want to be completely healed again. I want to be me again. I'm good, Josh. I'm good.
You might I get be a good, little emotional. Am because... I good? Am I good? Oh, my God. So, first of all, I've already said this already. I love you so much. I do. I don't know what you just said.
He said, "You don't ever have to apologize to me." Oh, is it some the sports fan den? Russ already lost the battle with you, Lori. He lost it from the very beginning. I'm not quite sure who wrote that, but thank you. I really hope that's true. I am willing to come out and do everything I possibly can to get Russ McKamey and all of his monsters and all his actors to pay for what they did, not only to me, but everyone else in that fucking shit show of a fucking chamber haunt. You know, I know it's even funnier. I don't know if y'all knew this, but after it was the beginning of 2016, Russ went bankrupt. He lost everything. He did used to have a warehouse. He lost it because he went bankrupt, which is why all he had left during, you know, October, all he had left was the van. It was just a giant, big red van, and it was called the Hostage Mobile. Oh, Russ even had a special license plate for that one. I can show you that, too. I got pictures.
Hey, that's my girl.
Yeah. I have everything. Russ went bankrupt, which is why he went from it being McKamey Manor, and then he changed it to McKamey Manor, quote, the chamber. He lied to everyone. He lied to me. He lied to everybody. There was no warehouse. It was only the van. Because of you telling your story, you have and will save others from us. Lindsay, thank you so very much again. Lindsay Hensley, oh my God, you're so sweet. And thank you, thank you, thank you. I will do nothing but tell everything that I know. And I know quite a bit. Everything that happened to me from the beginning to the end, I know I'm willing, I want to have my voice out there. I want my voice to be heard once and for all. After this, you know, once he's done, once Josh and Ron and all of you take this motherfucker down along with his actors, I finally just want to live in peace. I want quiet. I want to close my eyes at night and not remember and feel what he did. I want to move on but I can't. I feel like I was kind of killed in a way inside that van. And now there's like this spiritual side of me that wants what they killed inside of me to come back. I don't know. It's fucked up what I think. I want Russ and his merry fucking band of fucking fuckheads to be accountable. That's what I want them to be accountable for what they did and not just run away, you know, from the camera or whatever. You know, I want them to be accountable. I really do. Because it's not just Russ. It's all of them. It's everyone. I want them to be accountable for what they did to me.
Not sure. I know you're not on the
on the Book of Faith or the Bird of Twitter. But there's a hashtag that's trending. Oh, we can't hear you. We can't
hear you. Ron, can you hear me?
Perfect plan. Every time we can't hear Laura, let's pin the comment on the top of the screen.
What did you just say?
Wait. What? Oh, I called you the wrong name.
It's okay. I forgive you.
I will spank myself.
I'm a forgiving person. I don't hold grudges. Well,
I will spank.
Maybe.
Yes. Oh, naughty boy, Josh.
Oh, did you hear that, Josh? You are a naughty boy.
Naughty boy. I'm so sorry. Lori, I'm so sorry. So,
it's
it is fucking 4:30 in the morning. You have to forgive me when I replace
it. See, it's 4:30 by you, it's only 2:30 by me.
I know, and you still look fabulous, and I'm sitting here like, is there a Red Bull in my vicinity that I can just drink? So, fuck. I mean, you yourself have put me through an emotional roller coaster today in the past 2 hours that I've never experienced in my entire life. I appreciate everything that you have talked to me about off camera and on camera, and I hope you understand now that I'm the same person off camera that I am on camera, and that I, right here in front of all these people watching and that will see this in the future, that I wholeheartedly promise to take care of you no matter what the fuck comes of this. You're in good hands, whether it's with me or with Ron. You're going to be taken care of. And everybody who ever did you wrong will suffer the consequences one way or another. And I can promise you that, because I myself will not let this go down lightly. I don't appreciate what the fuck was done to you. I don't appreciate what the fuck was done to Christina Buster. I don't appreciate what the fuck was done to Carol and Holly. So,
Josh, there's way more to the story that you know. And whoever the sports fan then, we all got you back, Lori. Thank you. Thank you so much.
He is actually, just to fill you in, he is the guy who is facilitating this platform for us to speak on, because I'm ignorant as fuck on the internet. So he is facilitating this for us. So shout out. But we've been doing this for 2 hours. If you want to take a break, we can take a break. We can wait and go more. We have covered so much. In 2 hours, we have covered so much. And I know there's so much more to say that you released
there's
to me.
There's so much.
That,
there's so much. There's so much that you don't know, and that what people think they know, but they don't. But I know. I have everything. We are a community, and we aren't going anywhere. Susie Q, thank you so much.
I can assure you, in our little
thank you for your
group
support.
That you're
Everyone,
part
thank
of.
You for your support and your love and your kindness. I'm just a person that I'm just a girl or a woman that, you know, wanted to explore. You have a whole other family now, Lori. Lots and lots of support, even when Russ is gone. Thank you so much, Pink. Dagger, thank you. Seriously,
I didn't mean to interrupt you. The lag in this chat is unreal.
You know, when this happened, I had nobody for so long. And now I can't believe what's happening. I just can't believe it. Oh God, I look horrible.
No,
I can't believe what's happening. Is that people are starting to finally realize that everything that happened to me was the truth, and I've done nothing but tell the truth. and I never lied, I never cheated, I never deceived anyone. But there is so much to the story with Mikimi Matter that a lot of you don't know, but I do, and I have proof of everything. I've saved every single solitary message through private message, text, everything, pictures. I have everything. I have all the proof that will take Russ down. I also even believe sports fan done. The only people on Russ's side in regards to this have their eyes ripped out of their heads. I love it. You know, yeah, that's awesome. I'm not normally a violent person, but yeah, you know, I wouldn't mind that either.
Well, I can promise you the group that you joined, the truth, that little Mikimi Manor exposed Truthers Reborn group that you joined. I think that you're in it because it let me almost tag you in it earlier. I think you're in there. You're not in there. That is the community that is watching this that I can vouch for. So if you want to come in there and interact with people and feel free speaking to people, it is a safe place for you. I have a list of moderators long that are equally as morally valuable as I am. Like, we all love you very much, and we support every fucking thing you do, and we all share the same core values that Russ did not act alone, and that everyone who tortured and humiliated and bullied and physically fucking abused and mentally fucking abused somebody should pay the ultimate fucking price for the shit that they did. So you have a safe place to speak, and I dare, hold on, where is the camera so I can look the face? I dare a motherfucker to come after Lori on my watch. Please try me and see what happens. So you have a safe place to dwell and enjoy the interwebs and say whatever the fuck you want. And this is me saying this face-to-face in front of whoever the fuck wants to watch. I'm not here to make a fool out of you. I'm not here to make a fool out of myself or my moderators or anybody in my group. I appreciate you and love you so much for everything you have done for me tonight, personally, on and off the phone.
Thank you.
You're
so
a strong
much,
woman. You're a beautiful fucking woman. And we're gonna beat this shit, and we're gonna beat Russ McCamey's ass, and we're gonna beat his actors' asses. And with that pretty ass smile,
I would only love nothing more than to actually physically see it.
Well, I promise you, if you stick around long enough, you'll get what you want.
I'm not going anywhere. You know, I hid and ran away for a long time. I really did. I hid and I ran, and I don't want to hide anymore. I don't want to run anymore.
I don't know if you remember, but like, I reached out to you last year and you told me to go fuck myself, and I went and fucked myself for about a good year. So
I'm so sorry.
So yeah, here I am fucking myself.
I mean, you gotta understand when someone like me gets, you know, 1,000, we're not talking like a few, we're talking 1,000 people, you know, private messaging me and this and that. Now this year, if Lori is fine with it, we can do a wind down with any last questions for the stream. I'm happy to do anything, but this is Josh's show, so Josh has
this is Josh's.
I'm just here to
barely hanging on by just the pure faith I have in you, because 2 hours ago, this boy was dead, like asleep. So I've stayed up for you.
I don't want to hide anymore. I've done my hiding, and I've done my silence. I don't want to be silent anymore. I am here, and I am going to be the true beast that Russ and his merry mantle of fuckheads made me to be. But I'm going to be a true beast now. And I'm going to come out with everything. Every tiny fucking detail that any of you want. It's on. I'm open. Let's do this. Let's fuck Russ up. I'm done. I'm done hiding. Can I ask if the whole MM trauma ruined other haunts or you know, it kind of did. You know, Chris, like the Silvis brothers, you know, opened up a haunt, and you know, they made the fatal mistake of like teaming up with Ross, but they then ended it. Well, I don't know. Yeah, he fucked everything up.
So, first of all, as we wind this down, I'm going to destroy whatever's left in this. And this is my last cheers to you for the night, because I'm not pouring anything else in here, because if I do, well, I will not finish this live conscious.
Well, then, let me cheers you to them.
And that was a really good question that somebody just asked you, by the way. I was going to put you on the spot about that one day. I'm glad someone else...
Sorry, I didn't hear you. What was that?
I said I'm glad someone else put you on the spot with that question you just answered, because I was literally going to do that tomorrow night or tonight at some point. So I'm glad someone else did it for me.
Yeah, I'm open.
Cheers to you, you wonderful, beautiful woman.
Guy, Josh, thank you for having me. I can't thank you enough. You've made me feel more empowered to let my voice be heard and let my story be told. And, you know, I've locked it away inside of me so deep for so long that I can't hide anymore. I can't run anymore. And I have to let my voice be told. I have to let my story get out there. And without what happened to me, I don't think anything will happen to Russ. I just hope that everything that they did do to me reaches out to all these young women and men or whatever, boy, whoever, that there is a safe place, and it is not going through McKamey. There is a safe place. I'm happy to even whoever went through McKamey Manor, I'm happy to talk to them. I'm happy to like speak with them. I'm happy to listen and cry and do everything with these people. Because there's no one in the world that could ever imagine what I went through except for me. And I don't know. I don't want anyone to go through what I went through. I wouldn't live with myself if I knew another woman or man or girl or boy was treated and had done to me, done to them. I can't live with that. Alyssa, wishing you much peace and light, Lori. Josh, you are amazing for all you do and have done. Yeah. Josh is pretty much the bomb.com. It took me, what, over a year? Do you realize that? Is that right? Over a year, Josh?
I mean, literally the last time I messaged you, you told me to go fuck myself. And so, yeah. You said you were done with us MM fucks. You didn't want anything to do with
us. I did tell a lot of people to fuck themselves. Because at that time, like, everyone just wanted to use me. They just wanted to use me for my knowledge and what I went through just to make a story. You know, they just wanted the information that I have to, I don't know, like, build something for themselves, but they didn't actually care about what really, really happened to me before, during, and after my tour. They didn't care. They wanted ratings, publicity, whatever. And I got to a point where I was just like, no, I'm done.
I really don't talking. And like right here, I know we're way past 2 hours. Hold on, let me catch up. So right here in front of everybody, and some of the people commenting.
Sorry, you know, I just got my septum here, so it's like moving all over the place. So it's kind of weird. What is this? Anytime you want to be here with Josh and I, this platform will always be for you. Chaka. I can't tell you guys how much this means to me. I really can't.
I'm literally honored that I am sitting here talking to you, knowing the correct name to call you. First of all, I've been calling you Laura B for so long, but it's Lori B. Who would have fucking known?
Listen, I've been called much worse this whole experience.
Oh, trust me.
Laura,
I know.
is the least of the defensive or offensive names. And not that it's offensive. Like, I just, I don't know. Like, I've never been a Laura. I've always been a Lori. But Josh, I honestly cannot thank you enough for giving me this opportunity to talk and to just be me and let people out there know that every single solitary thing that I went through was nothing but the truth. I've always spoken the truth. I've never lied. I don't believe in lying. Where I come from Southside Chicago. And what we believe in is respect is earned and not given. And I've done nothing but earned respect. And for those of you out there that think I'm lying or I'm this and that, you know, go fuck yourself. Because where I come from, respect is everything. And the minute I lose respect in you, you're done. You're done in my life. You're done. So, I will not put up with one more solitary person that lies to me or deceives me. Because if you do, you got something coming. Yeah.
You're a brave motherfucker.
Be truthful with me as I am with you.
Yes, you
Sorry,
are
I'm
one
getting
brave...
a little spicy again.
No, we love it. Like, it's just crazy seeing, like, I literally just heard you 20 minutes ago, and you were just, you had me on the verge of, like, do I give a fuck about humanity anymore? And here we are shit-talking everyone. We are laughing, we are smiling, you have a whole community of people behind you, and we have made such great progress in 2 hours and .8 minutes. And
yep.
I'm just so happy for you. You literally look so much more relieved. Like just
so
from doing this
one
video.
You are welcome to vent and release anything you want here. We support you through this whole thing. Again, thank you so much. I only wish that I had this kind of support like right after I went through this, but you know, I guess patience is virtue. Is that how it goes? Yeah. Virtue. No. Yeah. Patience is virtue. Virtue is patience. I'm a patient person, and thank you so much.
Anytime.
Just thank you.
Anytime, privately or publicly, you ever feel like you want to get some shit off your chest, you know who to get up with. I think right now, and I think the conversation we had before this phone call that people were waiting on us so long for, and we're just, ooh, they're not doing it. So I feel like I can consider you a friend.
And like, Josh, I consider you a friend too.
So... Really?
It's been a long time since I was able to actually say that. Especially for somebody that I've never met.
Well, I want you to understand that I love you for everything that you have shared with me and everything you have been through and been strong enough to come out here and talk about. This community that is here behind me and the person putting this stream out, we love you and we support you 100,000%. And I dare a motherfucker... I dare a motherfucker to say something out of line to you because I and the people behind us will end their lives. You are the shit. You're a strong fucking woman, and you deserve this justice that you're about to get. And if I have anything to do with it, that motherfucker is going to rot in hell and get pissed on for the rest of his grave will be pissed on for the rest of his days. So, including the people outside of Rust that did the things they did to you, this don't end. This is not just this. I know you know how much this means to so many other people, but for you specifically, like, this means a lot to me to have a friendship with you. Whether we talked about this on or off camera, it makes no difference to me. I care about you as a person and your well-being. And I told you about the resources that we can offer you. And if you need any sort of financial help, mental help, physical help, whatever the fuck you need, please contact me. Seriously. We have people that will help you, whatever the fuck you need.
Thank you. Lori, you have no idea the community of positivity you are coming into. I'm almost speechless, and the only words that I have right now is just thank you.
We can't hear just, you though.
Sorry.
Be nice, but
I've been through like 3 years of torment, and Susie Q, thank you. I've been through 3 years of torment, and even though I was physically, mentally, and emotionally tortured in 2016 in that van, we are now in 2019, getting ready to go in 2020, and to this day, I still feel inside of me that I'm still being tortured, and I don't want to feel this way anymore. I want my soul back, and I want my heart back.
Look, I don't know how comfortable you feel looking me in my face right now.
Josh, we got another message here from Pink Dagger. It's about time people stop tiptoeing around Russ because of his threats and BS. And that's exactly what you're doing. This stuff is going to nail Russ, became his ass to the cross.
I told you, I promised you so much you came on here that you were coming onto a safe platform and everybody would have your back. I will look you right here in your face and tell you that not only the people that are on this little teeny tiny show with the few hundred people that are going to see this, we have your back 100%. And if you go on to do Ron's show, he's got some sick motherfuckers that can end some sick motherfuckers with the quickness.
Josh, do you advise that I go on Ron's show? Because I will if you advise it.
I'm not gonna lie to you. I've not had one personal issue with Ron. I know other people had issues with Ron for their own personal grievances.
I have been messaged by a couple of people to tell me to be weary of Ron. I don't know Ron. I don't know anybody anymore, and all I want is just truth. I don't want to be seen.
So let me, in the interest of honesty, Laurie, yes, please hold on. Fuck.
Okay,
I'm
here
out.
It is. Ron is a neutral person, just like Josh. Well, I really hope so.
I was going to drink a little bit before I said this publicly because I don't know how this is going to go over, but you know what? You've been so brutally honest with me. I don't give a fuck. I don't think this is going to change your opinion whatsoever. I do think that there was a certain group of people that made a certain chat and was sent to a certain person, and I think that a certain person reacted to that the only way a person making money from a certain platform would react. And I think a lot of stupid drama got started for a second, but I think it's all been smoothed out. And I think that if someone comes at you with some, don't do this, don't do that, I think that is really taken away from the amount of people that will hear your voice. I don't look into things. So you know how YouTube works, right? So YouTube,
yeah.
Basically, if you're a streamer with 50,000 people and you come across McCamey fucking Manor and you know, you're making a series about it and you know you don't know a goddamn thing about it and you're trying to figure out who's telling the truth and who's full of shit and all this and that and this and that, and I mean you're trying to get it, fuck it, you will have an equal chance to speak. I can 100% guarantee you will be taken care of, you will not be made a fool of, and nor will anything that you say you don't want to be used will be used. And this is me saying this publicly, because if somebody wants to make a fool out of me, go ahead and try, because I'm the same motherfucker in front of this camera that I am off the camera, and I think everybody that has ever dealt with me can say the same goddamn thing. You're safe with us. I will never put you in a position that will be compromising or that I'm not 100% sure that you're safe. And well, if you do have problems, please screenshot or message me or message Ron or anybody else the problems that you're having, and they will be dealt with accordingly. You have a support system right now that I don't feel you've ever had before. You have an army behind you right now.
I haven't had anybody since 2016. I had no support. I had nobody. I've done everything all by myself, and which is fine. You know, it's fine. I'm a tough motherfucking bitch. I am a tough fucking woman. Lori, one thing I want to say is that you may think you lost something in that van that day, but in reality, you took Russ down and out that day.
I told you, you have an army behind you right now.
Excuse me, I'm sorry. Just hold on.
You can cut your whatever you need to do. So,
I'm so sorry, but.
Like, literally, Lori, you've never, I know you felt like your own army for the longest time, but right now you literally have an army, a literal internet army behind you right now. You are no longer alone, and you're not going to fight any legal battle on your own. You're not going to fight any internet battle on your own. We're behind you every step of the way. And whatever the fuck we can do for you, we're going to fucking do it for you. It's not a load of shit. It's not. If you're going to go down for saying what you've been saying, I'm going to go down too, because neither one of us give a solitary fuck. So I appreciate you as a friend and everything you have done for me in the past few hours, in the past few days, but you have idea.
Fixing my piercing. I just got it on Sunday. Please. It hurts. Yeah, I just got my septum pierced on Sunday.
Oh, look. Yes. Shout out. Okay, where is the shout out for the tattoo shop? Where is it? Come on.
All right, for my tattoo guy. I would love to show a before picture of my McCamey Manor tattoo and then the after picture. Hold on, what is this? You still have the happy, bright personality that is infectious to this world, while Russ is miserable and in hiding and losing his haunt at this very moment due to exposure. Thank you again. Thank you. All I want is the truth. And all I just want is for no one else to go through what I went through. I want Russ in prison. I don't want him in jail. I want him in prison. So that way I know in my heart and soul that what happened to me will never, ever happen to anyone else. That as far
nothing
as
that ever happened to you will ever happen again. Ever.
As far as the tattoo, yes, my Kami Manor tattoo has been covered up. My tattoo artist name is Tommy Pino. He lives here in Denver, Colorado. Not only is he one of my best friends, he's also my neighbor, and he is amazing. I've had two giant piece tattoos from him. One of them being, as I mean, if you know me, I love Jack Skellington, the Nightmare Before Christmas. Except, in fact, you know what? I can show you this tattoo.
Yes, sneak peek.
This is my, hold on. Okay. I have to figure out how to do this here. Oh, shit. Offers Lori a virtual tissue. Oh my God. Oh, thank you. Christ. I do need a virtual tissue.
Where's mine? Where's my tissue?
I'm not quite sure how to show this tattoo. Yeah, it just goes like upside down. But I'm happy to show my boy Tommy's work, especially my Mickey Manor tattoo that he covered up. And it's even better that this Saturday, my boy is coming over to my house and he's going to finish it with shading and color and detail. And I guarantee that my Mickey Manor tattoo is completely gone. You know, Ryan Lawrence in my tour, I don't know, took something very sharp and like was cutting my tattoo off, and he told me I didn't deserve it. Now, what I deserve is for that to be gone. And my bestest friend and love the guy, you know,
We can't hear you.
God darn it. You can't hear me again?
You are the worst.
You know what? It's my phone. It's my phone. It's because I keep like grabbing my phone and like putting my finger on the volume. So I don't know what y'all missed, but again, Tommy Pino. Caspering tattoos is amazing. If you live in Denver, he will come to you and tattoo you. He's nothing but sterile and clean and awesome. My Mikami Manor tattoo is finally covered up, but this Saturday, my boy's coming over and he's going to do the rest of the coloring, the shading, and everything. That Mikami Manor tattoo that I had will never ever be surfaced on my skin again. It's gone. So fuck you, Russ. I was the first to get the tattoo, and I'll be the first to get rid of it. Because you are worth getting rid of, because you're nothing but a piece of shit.
And that's putting it nicely. Okay. I might have a poquito. I have just absolutely obliterated everything I told you I was going to obliterate during this, because you have just destroyed me from the inside. You've wrecked me.
Josh, you're so funny. You should get a fuck you Russ tattoo. You know, I thought about that, about getting a fuck you Russ tattoo. But
I was actually thinking about getting it around, like,
I don't want that man's name on my body. Fuck him. Nah. My fuck you Russ tattoo is my cover up, and it's gonna be fucking amazing.
Your fuck you tattoo is gonna be this goddamn video that is gonna be an internet tattoo, and this is gonna be the first knife in that fucker's heart. Because
let me see if I can like try and show you part of my cover up already.
Yes, because now I'm curious.
Let's see.
Because you said
so.
Look at that ink. Fuck.
Hold on. It's like everything is backwards to me on my phone. So, but this way, right, if you can kind of see it, there's a bear.
I'm sorry for the people that are looking up my nose or whatever the fuck is going on. I am literally trying to.
There's a bear right there. It's a big black bear that covered up the ink. And then going up, there's like trees.
And hell so yeah.
My bro is going to. There's a giant moon there. I mean, it's hard for me to see because everything's backwards right now through my phone. So I'm having a hard time like showing this to you. But just know that
it's wicked.
It's gone. And by this Saturday, it'll be completely gone. So, oh, maybe that works. Hold on.
Yes, we need to see the guns, Laurie. Flex their muscles.
Muscles. I'm just a crazy fuck.
A crazy I'm fuck that will probably beat the dog shit out of me. So,
you know, I will say this, you know, I'm small. I really am. I'm like 5'3½" and I weigh 135 pounds. But I will fuck you up. And I even told Lindsay Bowley that. She even tried to challenge me. I'm like, come on, bitch. I said, you know what I'm made of.
Shit, these fuckers. Now, look, now you have officially embarrassed me. Now I'm the girl in this relationship. So I'm like, I don't know if I could continue on anymore. I don't. Now I'm the victim. So, anyways, is there. We've been doing this for two and a half hours.
I'm not picking my nose. I'm just like fixing my nose ring. My
I mean, even if you're picking your nose, boo-boo, do what you do.
I'm not picking my nose.
It's fine. I pick my nose sometimes. Look it. See? There you go. Boogie for you. Anyway.
I'm not picking my nose. I'm just fixing my piercing.
So anyways.
Because it kind of tickles. I mean, I just got it on Sunday, and it just kind of tickles.
I could not, like, imagine, like, I have allergies as it is, and then let alone, like, my tongue ring bothered the shit out of me to the point that I just took it out. So now I'm just this big, boring, long-haired bastard. And now you have this thing. And I can only imagine how it feels like you have just boogies all the time. Like, I couldn't imagine what it feels like when it goes crooked. You don't have to, like, explain it. And I'm so jealous of your hair. Because your hair, like, I thought I had something wicked going on. And then you come on here. And you've just completely outshined me. Your smile is better. Your fucking hair is better. Your fucking story is better. It's just your tattoos are better. You are just...
I, Josh, we got another message. You smile more than me, and I'm known for my smile. I'm jealous. You have nothing to be jealous of. I want you to smile bright every day because life is a reason to smile about. Like the things you conquer and you accomplish that you do in your life is a reason to smile. I am smiling because, you know, what I went through didn't completely break me. I'm still here. I did not kill myself. I'm here, and I ain't going nowhere. If Russ McKamey will not take me down. He didn't the first time. You know what? I didn't hear no fucking bell, bitch. Let's do it again.
It's like that episode of South Park when Randy Marsh just starts fighting everybody's fucking dad at fucking ball games. It's like, I didn't hear no fucking bell. Like...
Right.
We, and, like, again, there's 100%.
One, what doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Yeah, exactly. I am the beast. I am the one that Russ McKamey thought he was going to break, and he didn't. So Russ has got something coming, and I can't wait to give it to him on a silver fucking platter.
And I can't wait to help you. So and we're I can't coming up.
You help me too. Like, I'm covered in like tattoos. You can see on this arm. It's so backwards. I mean,
hey, there it There it is. But where's the other half? Oh, she's gone. What happened?
No, wait. I'm back. I'm back.
Whew, magic. Whew. She's back.
I mean, I'm just covered in ink from head to toe. One thing that happened to me, though, after my tour is that...
Oh, I gotta get comfortable.
I didn't have an escape. As far as the pain that I was feeling inside of me, I didn't have an escape. So I escaped through, I don't call it self-harm because I was never a cutter, nothing like that shit. Fuck that. I'm fucking too strong for that weak shit. No, I did it through tattoos and piercings, and I don't know, like, it just... For any of you that have tattoos and piercings, you know exactly what I'm talking about. You need to release. You need to honestly release and get that shit out of the basement. And basement meaning your stomach. That's the way to do it. And so, yeah, I need to get shit out of my basement. And I have, and I just cannot wait till Saturday when my boy comes over and tattoos me some more. Oh, by the way, are you there, Ron? Or Josh? There you are. I don't see you moving.
Oh, I'm just, I just get very still. Yeah.
You know what's funny about me, though? And my tattooist and my husband, everyone can, like, verify this. I think I am the only person that when they are getting tattooed can literally actually fall sound asleep and snore. And I don't snore. I don't snore. But when I get tattooed, I am like out, like out. I am dreaming and I snore. It's so weird.
Fun fact number two for the night. Laura sleeps during tattoos. Lori sleeps through tattoos. Lori, don't fucking call her Laura like I have done twice tonight in public because I'm a dumbass. So don't. Jesus. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I'm an idiot. I told you it is literally officially 5 a.m. for the second night in a row because there is something about you that I just appreciate so fucking much. Like, you are so important to this whole thing, if not the most pivotal part. So thank you for sharing everything you have to us. No, I look like an egg with facial hair. So just calm yourself.
Lori would sleep during tests because she's a badass savage. Oh, I love that pink. Thank you.
So with me being a Debbie Downer for everybody in the comments that's 4 hours behind me,
it's five in the morning. Did you just call me a Debbie Downer?
No. Me. Please don't beat me up. So
I'm kidding.
So it's 5 a.m. for me. I know me and you have another. You are just the luckiest because you have just done shit mentally and through the sheer amount of shit that I had to drink to keep up with you during this. It is 5 a.m. for the second night a row in a look. See, it is 5 a.m. for the second night in a row.
Oh, did you see this, Josh? Look at it. It says, 99, Joshy boy. Too bad you can't be as tough as nails like Lori. LOL.
Lols. You're so funny. Hurdy, hurdy, hur. Fucking hell, man. You're welcome, you fucking bastard. Second of all. So, anyways, is there anything that, you know, you want to cover that maybe I was just too dumb or brain dead to cover? Just Google your beauty sleep, you fucking dickhead. So, yeah, anything, any last words before I go? Or
Yeah. I got a few last words. For those of you that are supporting me now, I can't tell you enough how much I love and appreciate you. I really do. Like, deep inside my heart, this has been really hard these last few years. And now we're in 2019, and all of you have just come together and done something that I never in a million years thought was going to happen. I was prepared to live with what happened to me all by myself, just like I have in the last 3 years. But now I feel like, I kind of have, you know, like, I guess a family, I guess. At one point, I have completely lost all hope in humanity as far as trust goes. And if it wasn't for Josh right now, I don't think I would ever trust again. So thank you, Josh. Thank you so much for you being you. Thank you. Thank you for listening to me. Thank you for just everything. I don't know what to say. Most of the time I'm pretty speechless, and I don't have a lot of words. It's just hard for me to have words after all the lies and deceit that I went through. But Josh, you truly opened my eyes and made me feel that I think I can maybe trust again. So I'm going to start with you, and I'm going to trust you, and I'm going to start with you, and then let's move forward, because I really would like to trust more. Says, good night, good morning. Thank you for being so brave and sharing your story. Don't stop smiling, Lori. Thank you, Alessa. Thank you.
I love how everyone calls you by the right name except for me. Like, it's been like a habitual
app. It's okay.
Oh my gosh. And you're just.
Yeah, I just want to thank everybody so much for just your support and your love, and that you finally all believe me as to, oh, Josh, it's just because you drunk and dead tired. Don't feel bad. I don't know. Did you say that, Josh? Anyway, no. Going back to me, I really just want to thank everyone here for just being so amazing and I don't know, listening to me in my voice as to what happened to me. And believe me, there was a lot more to come. I might have a surprise for you, but I'm not going to reveal it. You'll just have to wait and see.
I'm so pumped. I'm so pumped. So everyone, good night from myself and Miss Lori B.
And thank you. I love you all so much. I love all your support. With your support, I love you all. And thank you so much again.
Good night, everyone. And to you as well. Miss Laura, you can call me after this if you want.
I will.
So I guess we'll end this. I don't know how to end this. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm gonna leave.
All right. Well, thank you guys for sticking around, and it was good to have Josh and Lori both on the stream. It's 2:05 a.m. for me. I was gonna show you guys something if any of you guys wanted to stick around. Because, one second, let me see if I can pull it up. I just wanted to share an extra piece. the puzzle, I guess. I'm scrolling down my messenger on Facebook, so give me a moment. It's a bit back. And no problem, Melissa. Second. I'm gonna share my screen. So basically, this is an old message from Russ back when I acted. Just kind of gives you an inside thing on how Russ, like, how his mind works, I guess. And this was sent to us after 2011's haunt season. And this was back before Russ's haunt went insane, basically. This was when all the kids were acting, and there's like a couple adult actors that were good people. But unfortunately, that era had to end. Basically, and I'm gonna probably share this on Ron's stream once I go on. Because I think this is an important thing to show. It shows that, like, he has severe tunnel vision in terms of his view on the haunt. One second. No problem, Susie. If they're doing the San Diego thing today, then yes. But I don't know if they're moving on from Tennessee just yet. We'll see. And then also I can show this as well. One second. Trying to find it. So, like, this is kind of like behind the scenes stuff. Back when it was like considered a boo haunt, I guess. Except we were able to touch people going through, like, wrestle with them and hug them and, like, bear hug them to add to the scare. It's pretty, intense, but obviously not as intense as the time frame between 2014 and 2016 that Lori and obviously all the other contestants and the pictures of the abuse, like what they went through. Basically, this is like how big the haunt was in like all the rooms. I'd say there's about like 20 to 30 rooms that you would go through. It was like a 2-hour experience. And I'd say about four groups would go through every Friday and Saturday night. It was pretty interesting back then. And I think most people enjoyed it back then before he decided to go insane with his vision. But yeah. Anyway, I just thought you guys might be interested in like this being shared, because it's just something people don't see from behind the scenes back then. And I think it gives a new perspective on certain things. And yeah, I just wanted to toss that in there. I'll definitely have this platform open for like anyone that wants to add on to anything. Just you can DM me on Facebook, Brendan Walden. It's spelled like the spelling is on the stream right now because a lot of people misspell my first name. And yeah, I agree. It is crazy how it progressed and unraveled. It doesn't make sense to me how it could go that far, but it did. All right. Well, that was what I wanted to add to this. And I'm going to go to bed, and I hope you guys all have a good night, and I'll be around tomorrow sometime. Thanks for watching, guys. Peace.